Welcome to Racing for the Sun. This is once again another tech tip to help out you racers out there to be able to maybe get a little bit of an edge. I'm TJ Smith.
I'm Doc Smith.
And we're glad that you're tuning in to our little channel we have going on here. One thing I'd like to say is help out everybody with something that's important, like starts. I'm sure you, and I know I have, probably even y'all have been on the line before, ready for the gate to drop. And when the gate drops, you go to let the clutch out, it just dumps. The bike maybe doesn't stall, but almost bogs down. Everybody gets to jump on you. I'm sure that's happened. I know it's happened to me, and I've got to see it happen to you too before. But I've got good news for you and you. It may not be totally your fault. One of the very neglected parts on a bike is, what are we talking
the
about?
The clutch basket.
The clutch basket. This is what puts the engine's drive to that back wheel right there. And how that happens is, you have the clutch plates and they're squished in there, and everybody pretty much knows how that works. Well, one of the problems that happens is the clutch wears out. And what I've done is I've highlighted one here and we'll show you. I've covered the whole area with a Sharpie here to show you. I've sanded down just a little bit with the file so you can see exactly what I mean by the grooves in your clutch basket. And as you can see, those grooves are quite deep. And what that can do is cause your clutch to be notchy, almost like a light switch where it's on or off and not smooth to engage or smooth to take off.
So what we're going to do is show you a way to make it to where it's smooth again. And sometimes with some bikes, like these here, you don't even have to replace a gasket.
All you'll need to do is pull off the side cover, the little round clutch cover that's on the side. I have one over there. But if you pull that off on most bikes, the gear on the back side of the clutch is smaller than the basket itself. And when you release the bolts and stuff behind, I mean the nuts and behind that, you can pull this off and fix it. What you're gonna need, real simple, a nice flat file. You'll want one that's, you know, got some pretty aggressive grooves on one side and on the other side a more fine. Because what you're gonna do is you're gonna take that and you're gonna slowly and smoothly, and it does take a little while, file down those grooves. One of the most important things to do is make sure that you get all of these cut exactly even. And the best way to do that is to visualize where the clutch puts pressure. As you can see, this right here is basically how even you want it. You want it to be straight across here. Here's a little bit better view from the camera angle. This right through here. So as you're sanding through here, make sure you stay on this plane. If you get off here or here, it will give an uneven surface for the clutch basket to put pressure on the clutch plates, and then it will wear out just like it was, but very fast, and by that time the clutch basket may be trashed. So very important to make sure when you're sanding, you stay on this plane right here. And here is the clutch basket after it's been sanded down. It is quite a bit smoother, as you can see, and there is no divots, which is going to let the clutch actuate evenly as you release it. It is also important when you're sanding or filing this down here to make sure that you have a nice transition and not a very hard, sharp edge. Anytime you're making anything out of aluminum, or anytime something is stressed under aluminum, if there is a straight edge, it will create a potential for a crack. So make sure all these edges right here, have a very good taper to them. That way it helps keep the strength that the clutch basket already has.
So another useful tool is the calipers to make sure that you get the clutch basket the same width all the way down. And don't remove any excess metal that you don't need to, because if you do that, then it can weaken the clutch basket.
All right, we hope this tip will really help you with maintenance on your bike.
And may help you with your starts.
And that's definitely an important part of motocross racing. We thank you for tuning in. We hope you subscribe and maybe even watch some more of our videos. Help support our sponsors. And anybody who has a sponsor, those people help support our sport. So make sure you support the people that support our sport. Thank you and God bless.